I know dreams aren't always beautiful. Dreams don't always leave us feeling good. We can only stay high for so long before we face a low. This was an energy I knew I would find in my world. I was beginning to feel an uncertainty. Am I capable of upholding the light? Would I be able to balance the energies of myself and others? There were doubts and fears present in my thoughts, trapping me between worlds. If I wasn't careful, these worlds could collide. These worlds collide. Dark took over my guardian's planet, and as a result, it exploded. An entire planet no longer in existence. I couldn't imagine a world of darkness. I had to make a conscious decision. Let my fear of the dark energies guide me, or lead with the light. Thank you. After traveling down this dark path of destruction, my choice became clear. With my new knowledge and experiences, I placed an empathic protection around me so I could still emit the light amongst the dark, be positive in the negative, and fight for the good within the bad. This would be my driving force, and all my worlds would remain. Felt like forever was only an instant. I looked up from my newfound home to see my guardian back at my side. He urged me forward as if I was the one to decide where we were going to next. I realized all along I was a part of him and he was a part of me. We were one and the same, and I was also a guardian of dreams. I took his hand as we dove forward together into the bright light of our next level.
Thank you.
It began on his planet, within the galaxy Laniakea, our home supercluster in the sky. Laniakea was constantly under attack from dark energy. And like any galaxy in our solar system, some will come to an end, and darkness takes over. He was the last of his kind to try and save his planet, the last celestial knight. He fought, but it was too late. Not even his light could save Laniakea from this dark energy. Combustion, firefight, blackout. And so it was.
Hey, 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 hey.
Before we could travel on any further together, the Guardian beckoned me forward to a different place. One that felt new, but old. Familiar, but reintroduced, almost like a deja vu. The measuring of units of time did not apply in these worlds, but I could feel that this distance was much farther than the other places I had traveled to before. I did not know why he was so adamant to bring me here, but I trusted in him that every experience was a lesson, a reflection, or a mission. As soon as I stepped into the atmosphere of this place, a surge of energy bolted through me, head to toe. I looked down at myself, to my hands and my body. I was dressed in completely different clothing that resembled ancient drapes of a linen gauzy fabric. I looked around left and right only to see vast rolling hills of green grasses and massive mountain-like stone structures. As I looked closer, carved into these stone structures was an opening, a door. I entered following a light that was peering in through a carved out window, as if it was calling me inward. This was my home. This is where I had come from. The ancient, distant place that was sewn into the fabric of my life and all I was made of. It was waiting for me to discover it, so I could unlock my highest potential and powers. I had come from an ancient civilization of people that were known for their important work in changing mankind forever, evolving human beings with skills and tools to continue on in life and thrive at their highest. It was a magical place. It was my beginning. This was my forgotten civilization. As I opened my mouth to exhale, I candidly cried out in the language of our own. My forgotten civilization was forgotten. No more. During the hours I was awake, My mind raced with thoughts of the Guardian and where he would take me next. Maybe a dance along the stars? Or a walk in space with him, my guardian? Every fiber of my being, every part of me, was being called to the sky, to my dreams. I waited anxiously for nightfall, so I could dive deeper into this connection. I couldn't help but think, after all this, how life could ever be the same. invite you to the kingdom of dreams. Stop what you're doing and dream with me. This moment is for you. Imagine a place that's limitless, where living the life of your dreams is an absolute possibility. What does it look like in this place? How does it feel? Who is with you? Hold this place in your mind. Let go of any worries of today or tomorrow. Your only agenda is to let go and feel your passion flowing through your veins. Focus on your breath. Inhale the space you have created and exhale with the knowing that your dream has already been delivered to you. Moment of reflection. How do you view the universe? Let your thoughts and perceptions flow from beautiful intention and love. Do you have a guardian? Is there someone that walks with you? Call on your guide when you feel lost. You won't be lost for long. They are always there for you. Breathe out. Kingdom of dreams. If I told you, you wouldn't believe me. Do you sleep? When you sleep, do you dream? I am visited. I am seen. Maybe I'm a vessel channeling the galaxy. But who is he? I knew him as the guardian of dreams. Why he had picked me, I had yet to find out. But as long as I was dreaming, there he was. He was taking me places in my dreams, showing me worlds within worlds, past lives, portals to another universe. I felt this immense need to understand what was happening through me, but also collecting pieces of this infinite puzzle that I was now a part of. I yearned to know more about him, so he showed me. You are never alone, because now I am with you. Believe in yourself, believe in your passion, believe in your higher purpose. Dreaming became my awake, eyes wide open, eyes to the sky. head and my heart were expanding rapidly. I was now a part of another world, another level, all simultaneously happening while in the physical. It had me asking questions like, why are we here? What is our purpose? Soon, I'd be able to answer my own questions without hesitation. I could tell when the Guardian was near. Our connection intensified when we combined our energies. I had a sense of clarity and a sense of knowing with my every thought. The path forward was clear, and it was beautiful. I was so much more than a human walking the earth. I was a frequency of feeling. I was a powerful light warrior. The Guardian and I had a job to do. We were brought together to fight for the good, to fight for the dreams, and to dismantle the darkness with our work. Do you want to know what the essence of life is? The essence of life is connection. The essence of life is love. essence of life is love. Before this journey began, I was very lost and often felt alone. I could only wish for a life with more meaning and a deeper connection. Until I started dreaming, and my guardian came to me with powerful messages and unforgettable experiences. During this time, I embarked on a path discovering my greatest destination, my true self. It started with a dream, and now I had a purpose and a passion I would live out the rest of my life honoring. I would guide and heal others so they too could join us as guardians to save our planet Earth and its beautiful people. As I was reveling in these thoughts, I sensed my guardian was coming to me. But this time, he wasn't alone. I looked up to find a group of his people standing behind him. I was astonished as they were all looking at me. The guardian had brought them to me. They had been without a home since the dark energies took over their planet within Lania Kea, and it spontaneously combusted to black. I knew what I had to do. I could feel I was being pulled back to my home as I was beginning to fade from this realm. I quickly told them to come with me. I invited them to Earth. I will never walk this earth the same. I am forever changed. I often smile inside as I'm strolling through my streets at home, knowing my guardian and his people are here now amongst us, all lighting the way for our current light workers and the younger generations to come. This is the way forward. This is our future. We are all the guardian of dreams. I was processing so much. With all the questions and all the answers I had ever wondered about, I can't tell you how many nights I spent awake wondering if there was more to this life than just the everyday in the flesh. With the help of my guardian, I found my answer. Now it was my time to be a guide. All that I embodied, for the love of myself, but also for the welfare of others that I would cross paths with. We are in this together. There is no separation. Thank you. walking the earth in pleasured existence and profound connection. With the universe swirling inside you, step into the portal to access infinite energy of an immeasurable